about a week ago, it was decided that now we would slow down the negotiations. We will create a halt in the negotiations, and then we will come back and discussing later this year whether we continue or not. But it's absolutely clear that the majority of the people in Iceland, looking at Norway, looking at Greenland, looking at the future of the Arctic, still think that Iceland will be better off outside the Union. It's very important that the gathering here in Davos realizes that there's a new frontier, a new global frontier up there in the north, which is opening very fast.
What will you be telling people here about how Iceland handled the crises that you faced? The financial crisis, the volcanic crisis, the slow growth, the unemployment. What was the nub of it?
The core message from the Icelandic experience is that unless you involve the people at every level, unless you engage every community, even down to the local villages and farms, and you can galvanize your civil society in supporting the necessary actions and the needed policies, you're not going to succeed. If you try to force it from the government center of society, you will find it very difficult to get the nation back on course.
And as the world is recovering ever so slowly, what you're really telling them is that they're doing it wrong, because they're doing exactly what you're telling them they shouldn't do.
To some extent, that's right. And if you look at the Icelandic experience, and if you go back to the discussion we had here more than 3 years ago, what we were doing in Iceland and were planning to do, almost every government and financial authority in Europe told us this is the wrong way to go. But now, 3 years later, we can see that Iceland is back on course. We have dealt with profound crises, not just in the economy, but also in nature. So I think we have some very important lessons to offer.
Please join me at the riskometer. So it's where you think the risk to the global economy is in 2013. Is it the US with its budget woes, the EU with its debt crisis? You can put your cross anywhere, or you can go on a frolic of your own.
No, I think Asia will continue to be a very good area. The US will, I think, muddle through, but I think Europe still faces a very fundamental crisis.